Welcome to Ultra Healthcare Tutorial. Today's video is on basic pharmacology. This video involves introduction of basics of pharmacology. So first we have pharmacology. So the word pharmacology is derived from two Greek words, that is pharmakon and logos. Pharmakon means drug and logos means science. So in simple words, pharmacology is a study of the effects of drugs on the function of living system, or it's a study of drug and their action on the body. Next we have divisions of pharmacology. So there are two main divisions of pharmacology. First is pharmacokinetic and the second is pharmacodynamic. First we have pharmacokinetic. So pharmacokinetic means what the body does to the drug. That means after administration of drug, how body will react to it. So pharmacokinetic deals with ADME, that is absorption, distribution, metabolism and elimination, or we can say excretion. That means body will react to drug by these four ways. So you'll get to understand this ADME by this picture. First is absorption. So firstly, drug will get entered into your body through various routes. Here we have taken the example of capsule. Capsule get entered into your body through oral cavity and get absorbed into your stomach. So mostly oral solid dosage form get absorbed into your stomach, but in case of injection, drug is not absorbed. It get directly into your bloodstream. Second is distribution. So after drug get entered into the body, it will get distributed into your various tissue and cells with the help of blood vessels and blood. Third is metabolism. So in metabolism, drug will get breakdown in the liver where most of the enzymatic reactions takes place. So in metabolism, drug will get changed so they can excrete it. And the last is excretion or elimination. So finally, drug will get removed or excreted out from the body. Next we have routes of excretion for drugs. So there are majority of drugs that are eliminated out by various pathways, and these pathway involves major process and second is minor process. So first we have major process. So majority of drugs are eliminated out by pathways that involves kidney, hepatobiliary process, gastrointestinal and pulmonary, that is through lungs. And these few are the examples of drugs that are get eliminated out through these routes. And the second is minor process, and minor process pathway involves skin, sweat glands, saliva, breast, vagina and tears. So these all are the minor routes of excretion, and these few are the examples of drugs that are get excreted out through these routes. Second we have pharmacodynamics. So pharmacodynamic means what the drug does to the body. So pharmacodynamic means after all the process that we learned in previous slide, that is ADME, absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion, after that how drug will show its therapeutic effect. So this will comes under pharmacodynamic. So the majority of drugs produce their effect by interacting with their specific target. So there are four major targets of drugs, that is first is enzyme, second is ion channel, third is transporters and fourth is receptors. So these all are the target site for drug through which drug shows their therapeutic effect. Next we have summary of pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic. So firstly, drug will get entered into your body through various dosage form, whether in the form of tablet or in the form of injection or in the form of capsule. It will get into your blood plasma or into your blood concentration, that means into your blood circulation. And this is called, when drug will reach to your bloodstream, this is called pharmacokinetic. And after reaching into your systemic circulation or into your bloodstream, drug will give their desired effect or therapeutic effect, and this is called pharmacodynamic. Next we have routes of administration for drugs. So there are various routes for drugs. First we have oral route. So it's a most common route of administration for drugs, and in oral route drug is given through mouth. Second we have intravenous route. So through intravenous drug is given directly into your veins. So in intravenous route drug will get directly into your bloodstream. Next we have intramuscular route. Through intramuscular route drug will get directly into your muscle. Fourth we have subcutaneous route. So in case of subcutaneous route, drug is given between the skin and muscle. Next we have intraperitoneal route. So intraperitoneal route, drug is given within the peritoneum, and this peritoneum is a thin transparent membrane that lines the wall of abdominal cavity. And next we have topical route. So in this route drug is applied directly into your site of action. As you can see here, drug is applied directly into your skin. Next is suppository. So when the drugs are given through the rectum route, that is called suppository. Eighth we have inhalation. So the drugs that are in gaseous or in volatile form or aerosols, that are given through inhalation route. Next we have sublingual. So sublingual is a route when drug is administered under the tongue. And the 10th we have intrathecal route. So this intrathecal route is a route when drug is administered between two vertebrae in the lower spine and into your space around the spinal cord. So these all are the various routes by which drug can get administered into your body. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions related to this video, you can comment below or you can mail us at info@ultrahealthcare.in. Please like, share this video and do not forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching.